In this tutorial, I'm going to show you the difference between clarity, dehaze, and texture inside of Lightroom and Camera Raw. The first part, I'm going to explain what each of these adjustments do and where to use them. And at the end, we're going to apply them all to an image using brushes where you can see where each one shines. Before we go on, I want to define two terms which are going to help us: contrast and frequency. So contrast is the difference between the lightest and darkest point of this image. If we look at the darkest point on the left side, which would be these shadows, they're basically black and they map to the scale on the bottom. The rim light on her forehead is close to a pure white, and so essentially this is a high contrast image because look at the distance between the darkest and the lightest point of the image. The other side of this image though is a lower contrast. If we look at the darkest point, which is in the waterfall here, it's a gray. We can see it here on the scale. Lightest point is not a pure white either. And notice it's a shorter distance between the darkest and the lightest point. But generally we understand a high contrast image has deep blacks and bright whites, making for a very punchy image, whereas a low contrast image is more washed out because it lacks the deep blacks and whites. The second term to understand is frequency. Frequency just means detail. Now, I heard this said the best by Max Wendt from Adobe. High frequencies are details, mid frequencies are features, and low frequencies are areas. If we look at the lower left of this image where the trees, and especially in the ground here, this is fine detail. This is known as high frequency. In low frequency areas that lack detail or large areas of color, such as, you know, the rocks here underneath the waterfall, some of this area around there, things like skies are very much low frequency. And then when we look at a mid frequency, that could be something like the bamboo here, where there is some detail in there, but not super fine detail. Now, most images are a combination of high, low, and mid frequency. Now, this tutorial will work exactly the same in Photoshop and Lightroom. If you're in Lightroom, you're going to go to the Develop module and you're going to see them here under the Presence panel. If you're in Photoshop, you're going to choose Filter Camera Raw. Then you'll see them in the Effects. This is one of the few cases where Photoshop and Lightroom vary, but this is just in the name of the panel. The settings work exactly the same. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. I'm going to start with the oldest one, which is clarity. Now, essentially what this is doing is it's looking at the midtones in the image. And if you look at the midtones, it increases the contrast. Like, it doesn't affect the blacks and the whites too much, but look at those grays. See how much those grays are shifting. So what it's doing is it's actually putting a halo around the images, kind of very similar to what you would get with an unsharp mask. So if we go to Photoshop for a quick moment and we apply an unsharp mask, let's go to Filter, Sharpen, Unsharp Mask. And as we increase this, see what it does is it creates a halo around the edges. So what it does is it will lighten one side, it will darken the other side, and this gives the appearance of the image looking sharper. And as we increase it, you can see those halos get kind of crazy. Look at our image here. See, this is similar to what we're getting with clarity. It's not exactly the same, but it's similar. It really starts to affect colors as well as giving the appearance of clarity. If we want to use clarity on an image, it works well for bringing out detail in those midtones. Say, for example, the dress here on Crystal. As I increase the clarity, notice how it brings out that detail. Now be careful because it doesn't look good on skin tones. On a side note, when clarity first came out a few years ago, the grungy look was all in style. And in fact, this made it easy to get that grungy look. And for those who are looking for that look, this is how you get it. You turn clarity all the way up. You turn highlights all the way down. And then turn shadows all the way up. So when this novelty look first came out by Dave Hill, it became a rage for, you know, a short period of time. Now, I don't recommend processing most of your images this way, particularly these days, but it'd be disingenuous for me not to show you how you could get that effect. But where clarity might work well is on her dress applied locally with a brush, which we'll do at the end of this tutorial. Another area where clarity does work well is things like this landscape photo if we want to bring out detail in the rocks here. Can very easily be achieved. Another area clarity works well is images like this. Now, here's the thing. Often if I increase the clarity, I will also reduce the vibrance to get a different kind of look. Okay, so that's clarity, which tends to boost the contrast in the midtones specifically. If we go to the left, it will lower the contrast in the midtones. So dehaze works mostly on the low frequency areas or the areas without detail. What it does is it will increase the contrast in those areas and it will also boost the colors. It's designed to cut through glare on a photograph. And if you look at the bar here, this flat area would be considered a low frequency, and notice how much that changes. Also, areas such as the sky here or around the sax player in the background, these are low frequency areas, and notice how much they change. Notice the colors also boost. So dehaze works really well to cut through glare and haze. So say this particular image, if we increase it, we can cut through it. We can go the opposite way to introduce fog. It also works extremely well on things like skies and clouds. Now, when you use dehaze, be aware that it's also boosting the saturation. So when you do it, sometimes you have to also reduce the saturation to compensate. Or you could reduce vibrance if you prefer to go that way. Okay, so what about the newest of these adjustments, which is texture? Adobe first developed it for softening skin while maintaining pores, rather than just blurring the whole image. What it does is it ignores the very high frequency, but it affects more into the mid-frequency. So they're not the finest details, but it will affect smaller details. So as we increase it, see how it gives us the appearance of things looking sharper and crisper, and it brings out the texture without affecting the colors. So for example, look at this patch here under my mouse and the one underneath there, where we've got some mid-frequency details here. Watch how that really punches the texture in those. And it doesn't shift the color. Now we can go to the left and it will soften, almost like a blurring effect, but much more pleasing than clarity. If we go to negative clarity, see how it just doesn't look nice at all. But do negative texture, we can soften in a beautiful way. Texture was originally designed as a quick way to retouch skin on faces. So if we gently pull this back, you can see it softens the skin while maintaining detail. Now, if you go too far, it starts to look like plastic. So we can use this in a subtle way to soften skin while still maintaining details. So it was originally designed to just blur it, and then Adobe wondered, well, what happens if we use it the opposite way? And it's a pretty effective sharpener. And of course, if we go the other way, we can punch the details in this image. See how it really enhances the texture in the road and on the side there without introducing any color artifacts or any halos around the images. In fact, texture is my choice over clarity most of the time now. Clarity used to be different, but it's actually changed, maybe a subject for another video. Now, texture is closely related to sharpening. Let me go down to the sharpening here. So if we look at sharpening, it affects the high frequency. I'm going to push it too far so you can clearly see how it's affecting that very, very fine detail in the image. Let's bring it back to a more reasonable level. Now, if we look at texture, notice it affects more of the mid-frequency. So this can sharpen the larger areas of detail. So if you are sharpening an image, use a combination of texture and sharpening to get the finest and the small details. So all three of these sliders can be painted on locally, and let me show you a combination of using all three of them together. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a mask and we're going to make a brush. So with a brush selected, I'm just going to start to apply it to some of this area here where we're going to use dehaze on the low frequency areas. So let's adjust the amount of dehaze quickly. Notice when we're in the mask, it's now under effects, which is the same as in camera raw. So we're going to increase some dehaze and notice it starts to show the details in those low frequency areas. And I'm also going to reduce the saturation so that it doesn't shift the color, but it's only showing the detail. And with this, you could paint on the areas that you want to show more detail. So this area here with the haze from the sky and the mist from the water, we can cut through it and we can show more detail. So remember, my goal here is not to make a perfect image. It's just to show you the differences between the different adjustments and where you would use them on your own images. All right, that's dehaze. Let's look at clarity. So we're going to create a new mask. We're going to grab a brush. And we're going to grab our clarity. And let's slightly increase that. Then we're going to use clarity in the areas of midtones, such as maybe up here to bring these branches out more. And look what happens when I use it in combination with dehaze on these leaves. I'm not going to use it on the water. All right, let's create one more mask. And this time we're going to use it with texture. So I'm going to increase this texture and start to paint in some of the areas like the foreground here. Notice how it just brings out the detail there in that dirt. All right, so we can see the three adjustments there. In fact, let's turn them all off. So we look at the dehaze before and after, just by itself. Let's look at the clarity before and after by itself. And let's look at the texture before and after on itself. You'll notice it on the left-hand side. So if we put them all together, there's our image before and our image after. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you learned anything new, drop a comment underneath and let me know. So this is the third in a series of in-depth tutorials on the adjustment panel. So check out this video here if you want to know the difference between whites, blacks, and shadows and highlights. If you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. Until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.